I'm speechless.
Like it?
I'm overwhelmed.
Then why are you standing all the way over there?
Paperbacks, we had been making a profit there, Mort.
I know, but the company's taking a real hit.
And what is this with a pension fund? I mean, what's going on here?
The market.
Millions of dollars in campaign debt. I've got losses in 6 divisions. What else is going to go wrong today?
Excuse me. Out of my way.
You can't go in there.
All right, Montgomery. It's time you and I had a little talk.
There you are. Excuse me. Listen, I need to talk to you about Erica. I really think that she should have round-the-clock nursing care.
Yes, I agree. Oh. And I want all her visitors screened from now on in. It's quite vital that she stay in that bed and rest, because her life depends on it.
And if she objects?
Tell her that she must.
It's better you than me.
Well, you ready?
Ready if you are, Doctor.
Erica? Nurse, the king's not in her room. Have you seen her?
Oh, no, doctor. I just got... Much better now. Thank you. It's just that I have to go now.
You mind if I ask what you're doing here?
Oh, you mean dressed like this? Well, this is a disguise, of course. I'm trying to hide from the reporters.
I thought Stan Clater had you on complete bed rest.
Yes, he did. Yes. But I was never as sick as he thought. Isn't that silly? I mean, this is just so wonderful. Well, you look great. You look tan. Oh, that's right. You've been in South America. Well, listen, we should have dinner sometime, and we should catch up about all those things that you were doing in South America. But right now, I can't wait any longer. I think I'll take the stairs.
Erica, want to tell me what's going on?
Look, Cliff, please. I know that I'm acting strangely. I know that I'm talking fast and everything like that, but it's just the medicine, you know? It's the medication that I'm still on, even though I'm not...
I'll tell you what. Why don't we try to find Dr. Clater? We can talk to him about the medication.
I don't want to find Dr. Clater. I don't want to talk to him about anything. I just would like to go on the elevator, and you're in my way.
Erica.
Look, I'll phone you. I'll phone you about
this. Erica, look, we can do this loudly or we can do this quietly. You're not leaving this hospital. Do you understand that? You're not going anywhere. You are beautiful.
I wanted to please you.
Everything about you pleases me.
You don't think that I look silly?
You look like the woman I love.
I do love you, Jeremy. I love you more than I thought I could love anyone.
Silver. You make everything new again. A new beginning. For both of us. I love you. With all my heart. Are you sure?
I'm sorry, Travis. I told him you were busy,
That's all right, Polly. Why don't you both leave us? This won't take long.
Yeah, take a walk.
I'm on to you, Montgomery. I know everything.
Everything about what?
Everything about the evidence. About your doctored campaign funds, the evidence that so conveniently disappeared. You're as guilty as sin, Montgomery, and the American people deserve to know about it.
Chandler, I was exonerated.
Yeah. I had an expose all ready to go into Temple this week.
Oh, gee, well, isn't that a shame? Not only did you make a fool out of yourself in front of the election committee by coming up with all these false accusations, but you also lost a good story. Well, what do you expect from me? Sympathy? Well, you can forget it, because I lost a great deal more than that.
You solicited illegal campaign funds from Palmer, and then you destroyed the evidence. You belong behind bars, buddy. But I got you out of the Senate, didn't I?
Yeah. And you're proud of what you did, aren't you?
You're damn right I'm proud of it.
You know, we could have avoided all this. If you had come to me, we could have talked about this man to man. Instead, you had to go snooping and take all your false accusations before the public.
You're forgetting something, aren't you? Nothing I said was false.
It wasn't enough to discredit me either. But now, thanks to you, Erica is in a hospital bed fighting for her life.
I'm to blame for Erica being in the hospital. You're the one that lied to her, my friend. I told her the truth.
Truth? Morality? You don't give a damn about any of that. The reason that you came after me was because the politician that you had in your back pocket lost. So you decided to nail me and Palmer, Cortland, but the person who got hurt was Erica. And for that, Chandler, I am going to see you rot in hell. I swear it.
You made a mockery of the law, you and Cortland. And if that put too much stress on Erica, you just got yourself to blame.
You've got a hell of a nerve.
You know, the way I heard it, she was alone when she collapsed. I bet she's been sick all along. And you were just too busy with your own career to notice. If she and that baby are in danger, it's your fault, buddy. Yours and yours alone.
Get out of my office, Chandler.
I said what I came to say. Next time you make a mistake, you're not going to squirm out of it so easily.
We are in serious trouble, my friends. We have got a deadline breathing down our necks, and we have no cover story. Adam has pulled his expose on Travis, and so now we have two major holes in this magazine. Needless to say, I do not need to hear any brilliant suggestions about groundhogs or how to force forsythia to bloom before spring. Does everyone understand? All right. Ted?
Nothing. I'm sorry.
Nothing. Jim?
I'm blank, too.
What are we paying you people for? Chris, think. Think about your mother when she's at the dentist's office. She's waiting at the dentist's office. She wants to read a magazine. She wants to read a magazine like Tempo. What does she want to read about?
I don't know.
You don't know. Great. You don't know. He's a blank. She thinks people wants to read about groundhogs. This is just wonderful. Wonderful, guys.
Princess Di?
Overexposed.
Natalie Hunter.
Oh, you are funny, Jim. Hilarious, in fact, yes.
Too bad you couldn't hold on to her.
Okay, I blew it. I admit it. All right, but now we need a replacement piece. I need your guys' help. We need something topical, something timely, something that Chris's mother can read it while she's waiting at the dentist's office.
I have something.
Great. Let's hear it.
What about AIDS? It's topical, it's timely, and the public, people need and they want to know about it.
Wonderful.
Chris's mother is waiting at the dentist's office for root canal. You want to cheer her up by giving her an article on AIDS.
Tempo does not publish fluff, Barbara. Look, we could do a hard-hitting piece on how AIDS epidemic affects a small town. The citizens' reaction, the impact on their children, their fears.
AIDS,
we can do phone interviews
depressing.
All across the country.
Does not sell magazines.
People need to learn about it.
Well, then let them learn it in trend.
I suppose no one in this office has any ties with Bruce Willis.
I didn't need the money.
What was that? Barbara, you can't ask people to be creative and then put down everything they come up with.
And try and come up with something that I can use.
I think I hear the phone ringing outside.
And I think I'll get back to doing real work.
Me too.
Yeah, I'll make it unanimous.
Mm-hmm. Hold it! No one is leaving this office tonight until we fill up the holes. Spread the word. I want every staff member to report to me with ideas before taking one step out of this building.
Yes, ma'am.
Hillary? I didn't hear what you muttered, but a word to the wise. You mess with me and you are out of here.
You're the boss.
Disappointed, Erica. I thought you understood the importance of bed rest. I want you to promise me that you will not repeat this little escapade.
I promise. Are you comfortable?
No, I would like to be home.
Look, I know how you feel, but honestly, the hospital is the best place for you. I mean, we're taking good care of you and of your baby.
Joe, I don't want to be here.
Erica, you must. You must stay in this bed and on this medication. I know it's difficult, but all of it is for your own good, yours and the baby's.
No, it's not good for the baby.
Erica, please, give us some credit. We know what we're doing.
At your board meeting.
Look, I can stay till the nurse gets here.
Yeah, thank you, Cliff. Can I count on you to behave yourself?
Please don't tell Travis.
I won't, but you get some rest.
Don't worry, we'll make sure that she does.
Yeah. Got
them,
thanks.
I'll be back in a minute. I just want to return this, okay?
We'll be fine.
Lying, isn't she?
Erica.
This isn't what's right for my baby. I know that. I know that.
Erica,
now, you understand that, don't you, Cliff?
It's very important that you try to stay calm. Try to relax. Try. Everything's going to be all right. Would you like me to call Travis? Would that make you feel a little
better?
Oh,
no, don't do that. No. He's too busy. He really wants this baby.
Yes, of course he does.
And I do, too. I want this baby so much. I want this baby even more than I want my own life. Do you understand that?
Yeah. Of course I do.
Travis would never forgive me.
But there's nothing to forgive, Erica. There's nothing to forgive. Everything is going to be just fine. If you follow Joe's instructions and we try to bring this blood pressure down,
you
we're
don't
going to
understand.
Be fine.
Nobody does.
Give us a try. Please. Just give us a try.
Look, ever since I found out I was pregnant, I have been so careful. I have avoided anything that would harm this baby, everything that would harm him. I haven't had any alcohol, not anything, not sleeping pills, not one aspirin. I have treated my body like it was a temple because I was carrying something so precious, a gift, a new life.
Easy. It sounds like you did everything exactly right.
All right, then look at me. I am lying here and I'm helpless. And you are pumping chemicals directly into my bloodstream and that's going into my baby.
Erica, this medication is safe.
No!
I promise you, it is safe. Believe me, it is.
You're just a doctor. You have to say that.
No, I don't, Erica. I'm saying that because it's true. And because for the next couple of weeks, I want you to be fine so that your baby's lungs can develop to a point that we can deliver it safely. I'm giving you my word of honor, Erica. No one is giving you anything but the truth.
No, I don't think so. I think you're lying to me, and I think everybody's lying to me.
Erica.
Just leave me alone. Look, please, Erica. Leave me alone.
No, please. We know that you are having a very hard time, and we want to help. Is there anything at all that we could do to make it any easier for you?
Nick Davis. I would like to see Nick. I would like to see Nick. I need to talk to him about something. He's the only person who can help me. Will you find him for me? Please tell him that I want to see him.
Ruth?
I'll stay with her, sure.
Please, Cliff.
I'll do my best. Do my best.
Okay. Okay, Bill, I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye. Oh, boy, does he give new meaning to the phrase, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. Oh, great. Oh, the transcripts. Did you finish it?
Yep, including the last few notes you added.
Oh, great. What's wrong?
Nothing. I was just moved by what you said, that's all.
What, to Bill?
Oh, no, Natalie's story. Brooke, it's really wonderful. The way you worded your questions, the way she described her feelings. I didn't just read that, Brooke. I felt it.
Well, I hope everybody feels like you do. Natalie suffered a lot. I just hope maybe reading about what she went through will maybe help somebody else.
I'm sure. I'll get it.
Oh, okay, thanks.
Hi, Terry.
Hi,
how are you doing? Is Brooke here?
Oh, yeah. Hillary, hi. Come on in.
Brooke. You look nice.
Thank you.
Listen, I'm sorry I didn't call. I just thought of it in the driveway and it was too late, but I need to talk.
Aunt Phoebe?
Barbara. I hate her. I loathe her. I despise her. She makes me sick. I couldn't
all
go
right.
on. I'm not kidding.
Okay,
calm
down, all right? Just calm down. Tell me what's going on.
Cy quit.
Cy's the best production manager in the business. How could she let him go?
Oh, well, of course, she tried to worm her way back into his good graces, but he left anyway. I mean, I don't blame him. He hates her. Everybody hates her.
Brooke, it's not the same there without you. It's stifling. It's like a prison in there. Look, Brooke, please, I know that I really blew it when I was going to Chicago and I canceled my interview with Trend, but I am a good, hard worker, and if you maybe just throw a good word in for me, maybe they'll give me another chance. I'm begging you.
Hillary, I can't.
What?
I'm sorry, I can't do it.
Oh, Nick. Thank you very much for coming so quickly. I appreciate it.
How is she?
Agitated. Insisting on seeing you. So, do whatever you can to calm her down. She's not in good shape. Say whatever you need to. Do whatever you need to calm her.
I'll do my best.
Thank you. Nurse will wait right outside.
I knew you'd come. I knew that I could count on you. I have to tell you something. I have to tell you about a dream that I had. Well, it was a dream, but it seemed so real, Nick.
Right.
I could smell his cologne.
Erica, just
I could touch
down
him. I could feel his cheek on mine.
Oh, I understand, Erica. Be
I could
calm.
I have to tell you about this dream. I have to
I
tell
wanna
you.
I want to hear all about it, Erica. But now listen, first you're going to have to do what I say. Hey, this is me. Now, come on. I want you to relax, please. Deep breaths. Come on with me. Deep breaths. Deep breaths. That's right. One more time. Just be calm, sweetheart. Now tell me about your dream.
It was my father in his garden. Mm-hmm. And I was there. I was waiting. I was hoping. And he came there. He did. He showed up. And I begged him to take me back to California with him, to live with him, but he refused. But Nick, he told me that I have to learn what I can keep, and I have to learn what I have to lose.
Erica.
What I have to lose,
Erica,
Nick. It was a message to me.
Just calm down,
it was a message
please?
From my father to me, Nick. Don't you
now
understand
listen to
that?
Me, Erica.
Nick, he was reaching out from heaven, and he was trying to prepare me for what I have to lose.
Sweetheart, it was a dream. That's all it was.
It was my baby.
No.
I'm losing my baby.
No, listen, Erica, hear me. There is nothing wrong with your baby. It was a dream and nothing more than that.
No, it wasn't, Nick. It wasn't. I never had a dream like that before. Never.
Well, of course not. I mean, look at you. The medication, the high blood pressure. It's no wonder. The dream was just a side effect, that's all. And darling, you mustn't let it upset you.
Barbara said that the only reason I got pregnant is because I wanted to trap Travis. But that's not true, Nick. That's not true.
I know. It's
I want this baby, Nick. And I don't want to learn how to have to lose him.
Of course not. But maybe that's not what your father meant at all.
Oh, Nick. What else could he mean?
Well, maybe he meant that once you become a mother, you'll have to give up your career. That's what you have to lose.
Because I always wanted too much. Because I'm greedy. And now my punishment. This is my punishment. This is my punishment.
You want me to get that?
No, no. Oh, yes. Yes, it's probably Travis.
Just calm down.
Hello.
Erica?
Yes, darling, hello.
Erica, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm really feeling better. I'm here. I'm lying in my bed. I'm very still and I'm very calm. I'm really much better. How are you?
I'm lonely. How would you like me to sneak in after visiting hours tonight?
Oh. Darling, you know that you could just do anything you want. You know how much the nurses love you. But I'll tell you what, I'm really tired, and I think that it's best if I just sleep tonight. So why don't you just stay there and you finish all your work, okay? I know you have a lot to do, and don't worry about me anymore, because I'm fine.
I love you.
I love you too.
Sweet dreams.
Solid antiperspirant.
Look, I just want you to understand why.
Seems pretty clear, I guess. You just don't want to help me?
Hillary, no, come on, it's not really that simple. First of all, I am a contributing editor for Trend Magazine. I don't make any of the hiring decisions.
Oh, no. I know that. I just was wondering if maybe you could just give me a recommendation. Is it that you don't think I'm a serious writer, that I have rotten ideas, or that I'll go flitting off to some island? I'll sit down at my desk and I will pound out stories.
Hillary, you know, I think you're a fine writer. I have great admiration for your style and your ideas.
Sure.
Hillary, I never hired you. I would not have hired you for Temple if I didn't think you could do the job. Come on. You've proved your talent. You can't seriously think either that I hold going to Tahiti with Mitch against you. That's crazy.
Brooke,
it has nothing to do with that.
I know I'm a good writer. Why won't you help me?
I know you're a good writer, too. It's because of Adam, all right? I mean, he owns Temple Magazine. He is my husband. And I really can't go around raiding Tempo's staff for Trend. It's not going
right.
to be a Tempo. Barbara is running it into the ground.
Well, then you can't let that happen, can you? Because you and I worked too hard
Brooke,
for that magazine.
If I was in charge,
Hillary, there is always going to be a hard period when someone new takes over a magazine, particularly if that someone has little or no experience. I think what you have to remember is that it's the magazine, it's Temple that's the most important. It's Temple that you have to be loyal to.
Like you?
It's not fair. Look, Adam is my husband, all right? I left the magazine because it was putting a lot of stress on our relationship. I really had no choice. Same way you had no choice when you canceled that interview in Chicago for Trend because of Mitch.
I know. I'm sorry. I didn't mean
that. Oh, it's all right. I'm sorry. I am sorry that you're having such a bad time with Barbara. But I think you should hang in there. I am sure it's going to get better.
Oh, and if it doesn't,
I will leave no stone unturned.
Let's just hope I don't commit first-degree murder.
You'll be fine. You'll be fine. You just have to keep things in perspective.
These are great. What are these?
I'm doing a story about South America. There's a very interesting woman in Pine Valley, revolutionary.
As in a freedom fighter?
Mm-hmm. It's going to be a great story.
Wow.
One word to Barbara and I'll kill you.
Oh, don't worry. Well, I better get back to the salt mines.
Oh, you're working late.
Oh, every night.
I'm sorry. I really am. And I do appreciate your understanding my position.
Oh, well, just please keep me in mind.
I will. I will, Hillary.
Thanks.
Say hi to Mitch.
I will. Take care. Bye, Terry.
Bye, Hillary.
Oh, Terry, can you try to get Pilar on the phone for me again?
Sure.
Thank you.
Poor Tempo.
You sure Hillary's not at the desk?
Well, she's running an errand.
An errand?
With no explanation, no asking permission. You call that professional behavior, Chris?
Miss English always let us structure our
time. I beg your pardon?
Brooke always let us do whatever...
How many times do I have to tell you not to mention that woman's name again? Don't you understand English?
You said it. I didn't.
I am the editor of this magazine now, so I make the rules. Employees do not leave the building unless they get permission from me. Am I making myself clear enough? You'd understand now, Chris.
Yes, perfectly, Miss Montgomery.
Good. I'm going to get this place running smoothly. I'll be the best editor Temple has ever had. You just watch and see. Send Hillary in the moment she gets back, and if anyone calls, I'm in a meeting, please close the door on your way out. Thank you very much. I will make this work. I know I can. I have to.
I don't know how much a man can take, Barbara. Being married to Brooke is like trying to walk a tightrope across Niagara Falls with an anchor tied to me, dragging me down.
You're coping beautifully, Adam.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't be unloading my problems on you. You have enough to think about. Now that Tempo has been named the best magazine in America in a nationwide survey, just isn't fair.
You let me worry about it, okay?
And the tedium. I'm so tired of hearing about bus schedules and nursery school. Beer and macaroni for dinner instead of caviar and champagne.
I know.
And the articles she writes, that dull, plodding diatribes with a lot of easy little platitudes about love and honor and the First Amendment. It's just political drivel.
You're right.
And her clothes. Good grief. Have you ever witnessed such frumpery? Woman buys everything straight off the rack. It's enough to drive a man over the edge.
She just does not understand you, Adam.
No, she never did.
And she never will.
I need a woman with fire, Barbara. Someone lean and hungry. Someone creative, who understands and appreciates all my fine qualities.
Like me?
Yes, Barbara. Barbara, like you, Barbara. Exactly like you, Barbara. 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 Am I interrupting your daydreams, Barbara?
Everything I am, and everything I hope to be, is yours.
Daydreaming? Of course not. I was doing some private brainstorming, trying to come up with some replacement piece for this expose on Travis we can't print.
And you haven't come up with one yet, huh?
Oh, of course I have. I've got plenty of ideas. It matters on which one I choose, Adam. You know, I would love to discuss this with you. I would really like your input. A great deal. Adam, you didn't come here to say hello, did you? What's wrong?
Sorry, I quit.
Oh.
Oh. We have no replacement article. The best production manager in the business just walked. What are you doing to Brooks Magazine?
Brooks magazine.
Brooke worked very hard to put Tempo at the head of the pack. I'm not going to stand by and watch it go down the tubes.
Adam, I am upset about Cy leaving, too, but I have a great deal of faith in his assistant, and I put out feelers with headhunters.
Well, it's not just production. Tempo's reputation is built on solid journalism. Now, share this brainstorm session with me.
You want solid journalism? Okay. You got it. We do a blockbuster roundup on AIDS. Sort of a progress report on disease control.
AIDS?
Yes, we interview people across the country. People focusing on how people feel and react about this. Their fears, the way it affects the children, the impact on the children.
No, no way, not now.
But it's timely, it's topical, Adam.
Leave AIDS to the weeklies. We need something new, something fresh that hasn't been done before, something far-reaching.
You know, it's so late. Why don't we go someplace and relax? Just the two of us, quiet place, and we can just kick some ideas around. What do you say?
Tonight?
Yeah, we could go to my place. I got this great old bottle of brandy I've been saving.
And my wife's expecting me. Finding new ideas for stories is not my job, Barbara. It's yours. A job you're not going to have for much longer if you don't come up with something very fast. See you tomorrow.
I thought my AIDS idea was depressing. Thought it wouldn't sell magazines.
Travis, I'm sorry. The loan came up for renewal at precisely the wrong time.
So you're calling it in?
Might have to.
Hunt, you know me. You know I am good for the loan.
I also know what you're thinking. Your father and I were best friends.
All right. 6 months. Extend the loan for 6 months.
Your father would be the first to understand. Since October, we've had one rule and one rule only at Mossberg Investments. Placate our investors and do nothing but nothing to rile them.
Hunt, we've paid all our interests right on time, haven't we, Mort?
Absolutely.
We've made all the payments?
In volatile times like these, no one can afford to take risks.
A lot more has changed since October than just the market, isn't that it?
For your father's sake, I owed you this news face to face.
I did not accept any illegal campaign contributions. The Election Commission dismissed the charges against me because there wasn't a single shred of evidence.
You resigned, and that makes you look guilty. Now, my board says we can't afford to alienate our investors, and they're right.
This was a smear campaign that was started by Adam Chandler. You know me, Hunt. Why don't you believe me?
Look, I know you've had it tough for a while, running for office, not minding the store, not to mention the problems you've had with your fiancé. You need some time off. Am I right, Mort? Take it easy, Travis. I'll be in touch.
Well, it's not the end of the world.
That son of a...
Come on, Mossberg is a frightened old man.
I'm not talking about Mossberg. I'm talking about Chandler.
Come on, Travis. You're wasting your energy.
He's been breathing down my neck for years. Well, I am going to make him pay.
Don't you, Jeff?
Listen, Terry, thank you for getting everything set up with Pilar.
Oh, you're quite welcome. She sounds nice. I think you'll like her.
You know what? I don't think you have to come in that early tomorrow morning. We got so much accomplished today, so why don't you take some time off?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Thanks.
Hello, Terry.
I'm leaving.
How is your protege's first issue of Tempo coming along?
She's not my protege.
I heard Cy took a hike.
Good night, Terry.
Night. Have a nice evening.
Mm-hmm. Well, how was your day?
Productive. How was yours?
Brutal. Who told you about Cy?
Never mind. So how is Barbara?
I don't want to fight with you.
What? We're not fighting.
Come here.
What for?
I want a hug.
Is this a trick?
Not this time.
What's wrong?
Bad day.
Business?
Everything.
You want to talk about it?
Is there any more coffee?
Adam, what is it?
I'm going to the prison tomorrow.
Ross.
It hurts to see him like that.
I know.
Beaten. Behind bars. How could that happen? He was such a decent kid. He still is. And Stuart is in love with a woman who's dying. There's so much pain, Brooke, and I can't do anything about any of it.
We're family. We're all here to help each other.
You're the only thing in my life that's not screwed up right now. Not now, anyway.
Don't.
I'm so lucky to have you. I know that.
I hope so. Because no matter how you screw up or how rotten you can be sometimes, I love you very much.
You heard, Adam. It's a lousy idea.
It was my idea.
What difference does it make? Yours, mine.
And it was so lousy that you thought you'd steal it?
Oh, grow up, Hillary. You don't have a copyright on your ideas. And even if you did, I am in charge here. Whatever comes up in this office is my property. So what do you have for me? I want something new, something fresh.
Yes, I have something new. Fresh idea.
Good, let's hear it.
An in-depth examination on executive women who sleep their way up the corporate ladder. With other women's husbands, of course. Think of it. Office seduction techniques, how to score big with the boss, and who better qualified to write it than yourself?
I hope you and Mitch don't have any plans tonight.
No, you didn't like my new fresh approach?
I want every writer and editor in this office in 10 minutes. No one is to go home until we plug up those holes. Okay. I don't care if it takes all night.
Whatever you say.
And Hillary! Just so we understand each other, I don't find you cute or amusing. Remember that.
Quick. How is she?
She's sleeping restlessly.
She's wearing herself out.
Yeah, I know. I know. If she keeps this up, she could go into premature labor.
And lose the baby? Oh, let me tell you, there is no way in this world Erica can deal with losing that baby.
I know. Problem is, we have a catch-22 situation. We try to keep her calm, try to keep her blood pressure down, but the condition itself causes mental aberrations, and they can have serious consequences.
You're already having serious consequences.
I know that. The trouble is, we can't get inside her mind to stop the worrying. Right now, all we can do is hope for the best.
This is Charles.